coalition of non-Arab countries in airstrikes against Iran-backed Yemeni rebels and their allies for almost 3 years. The United Nations is calling the Yemen situation the world's worst humanitarian crisis. Vice President Mike Pence is in Israel tonight after a rousing welcome today by Israeli lawmakers. Pence says the U.S. embassy move to Jerusalem will come sooner than expected. And while Israel, of course, celebrates, Palestinians and their allies condemn the U.S. policy. Of course, one of David Lee Miller is traveling with Vice President in Jerusalem tonight.
Vice President, the first U.S. Vice President to speak before Israel's parliament, the Knesset. I am here to convey a simple message from the heart of the American people. America stands with Israel. The Vice President was interrupted numerous times for applause, and once by Arab members of the parliament, who held up signs declaring Jerusalem as the capital of Palestine. They had to be forcibly removed. Mr. Pence received a standing ovation when he revealed the details of when the U.S. Embassy would be relocated from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, Israel's capital. In the weeks ahead, our administration will advance its plan to open the United States Embassy in Jerusalem. And that United States Embassy will open before the end of next year. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who joined Mr. Pence this evening for dinner, congratulated him on his speech before Parliament.
It was a powerful expression of the enduring bond between our two countries.
The Palestinian leadership boycotted Mr. Pence because of the U.S. position on Jerusalem. A Palestinian lawmaker accused the Vice President of using his religion to set diplomatic policy.
On
Sunday, while in Amman, Mr. Pence met with U.S. ally Jordan.